Good morning and welcome to Fen Tomato Farm. Today we will show you with a few tips how you can grow the best, tastiest tomatoes you'll ever grow in your life. If you follow the recommendations that we will give you, you will have the season which will be the very, very best season you've ever had. Under today's conditions with the virus so prevalent, I'm sure you've got the time, you have the patience, and if you follow our step-by-step guide, you'll have fantastic crops for this year. So, here we have a tray for compost. We use these reusable trays. They're 30 centimetres wide, they're 40 centimetres long. But that's obviously because we are sowing 150, 200 seeds in each tray. You probably won't need to have so many plants, so you can use a pot like this. This is a 13 centimeter pot. So we will fill it with a bit of potting compost. You fill the pot 3/4 full, as you can see. And just use an empty pot then, just to go lightly around, just to make it that the surface is level. It's flat and it's level, if you can see that. That you've got no... So tip number one, when you're sowing the tomato seed, make sure that the compost is not like concrete, but not fluffy. It's just firm. And when it's firm, you've got then... a level base in which to sow your seeds. So today I will sow the variety San Marzano. We grow quite a lot of San Marzano for sun-dried tomatoes. So then they've got their own space, their own room. So then what you would do, cover them with a little bit of compost. I find it very handy. Tip number two is with spacing the seeds out, use a pot that's got the holes already made in there. And if you put a little bit of compost into the pot, then just give it a little shake. This compost I've added just a small amount, maybe 10% of vermiculite. That's to make it that the compost is airy and it's light. There you go. And that's ready. When you've finished that, you need to write your label. And then stick the label in. Then you can water the compost, make it nice and moist, and put it in temperatures of around about 22 to 25 degrees. They will germinate, that's to have the seeds start to grow, to sprout out, germinate within 48 hours, that's 2 days. And if you can do that, tip number three, you have the plant, then it has vigor. It's already started on the right path. If it's too cold, yes, they will grow, but they'll be very slow in trying to produce things. So get your watering can, and again, not cold water. The water, tip number four, never water your seeds with cold water. If you can put your hand into the water and it's stinging cold, it needs to be round about 18-20 degrees. So give it a little water like that. There we are, and that's now ready to go. So you need to cover the pot to keep the moisture in, keep everything nice and moist so that it doesn't dry out too quick. So for this purpose we're using cling film. You can use a bag, you can use a tin foil, anything, just so that it has got like a little bit of its own microclimate. Okay, here's a tray of tomatoes that was sown 7 days ago. This is a beef tomato, and these are called Monty. And you can see 7 days ago they are quite well established, quite well up to the task, and they're already got the cotyledons opened up. They're away with it. Here in the growing room that we've made, we're now potting the tomatoes up so that they have a little bit more space. They have a little bit more light, individual light, so that the seeds don't draw up, so they become too thin and too leggy. These now are at a stage where they'll start to compete for the light, and it'll be at the detriment of the plant. Okay, now we've got the plants grown in the trays, the second step is to transplant them into pots so that we can a little bit more space, so they've got room to grow. So from this tray here, if you can just see, they are quite dense, they are quite thick, and so you would go underneath with the compost and you would lift the roots out first like that, and then when you've got the compost out, you would then separate the plants so that you touch the plant from the cotyledon like that. You don't touch the stem, you don't touch the root, you hold the plant with the cotyledon. Look. Get out the cotyledon.
That's the first leaf.
And that's the cotyledons. There you can see the first true leaf. By grabbing the plant by the stem, you'll damage the stem at this stage. That is why you should hold them by the cotyledons. The damage won't show now, but it'll show in 2 or 3 weeks' time as the stem starts to develop and the plant will die. Then can just make a little indentation and just cover with a little bit of soil, a little bit of compost. Because these are very shallow, I'm not sort of planting it in a pot. I'm laying the stem down and then just slightly and lightly covering it with compost. So making a little indentation into the pot, into the space there, laying it sideways so we can put the stem more into the compost. This will increase the rooting area of the plant, and as long as you leave the cotyledons then above the compost, then you're fine. If you bury the cotyledons too much below the compost at this stage, you'll attract botrytis and damping off, and in doing that the plant then will rot and it will die. The third stage in the process of the tomato, we've shown you with the sowing of the seed, we've shown you about pricking out, how to space them out, we've put them into this 30 cell tray so that each plant has its own space, its own light, so they don't draw up too big. And now today we are going to pot them into 13 centimeter pots, another process where they will be in propagation, they will have their own space, a little more, where they will have a support and a clip, then they'll be ready for planting in 3 weeks time from here. So we've put them, as I said, into the 30 cell trays. The compost is not very deep, but it's giving you the area. As you can see, the root system there, which is very nice, all nice and white. This is a variety called Romana, which is a big plum, big red plum. If you look really close in the top, you can see the truss all starting to appear. So I'm estimating 3 weeks, which is about the end of February, we should have tomato flowers ready for pollinating. So we get the plant out of the tray and we will put it into the compost, take a little bit out the top, put the plant into the compost, and ekasha. There we go, it's all done.
We need to fix.
So when we've done that, just to support it, we have a split cane, a little bamboo cane that's about 16 inches or 40 centimeters long. So we then just put that in the pot like that, and that supports the plant. There is a little clip that can go on there. We have these clips. These just give the plant a little bit of support. They're very easily bought at your local garden center. Just come round into a circle and just clip like that. So what we'll do is we have the plants like that and just put the cane, the clip around the cane, you see, like that, click it together, and there we are, that's supported, doesn't fall over, and away it goes. But that plant is 5 weeks old today.
That's a lovely plant.
That's 2 weeks, just over 2 weeks in from sowing to pricking out. 3 weeks it's been here into the grow room. We built a purpose-built grow room to put these on, to grow these on, and now these are going to go into the propagation area where they have a little bit more space and a little bit more tender loving care before they go out into the grow bags in the glasshouse. It's a little noisy outside, it's very windy. It's about -3, wind chill about -6, -7, very cold. But in here we have the tropics. It's a lovely balmy 20 degrees at the moment in the daytime. Night time we're around about 13, 14 Celsius, not trying to push them too hard at this point. The tomato plant has been in the 30 cell tray in the growing room for 3 weeks. It had 3 weeks before potting up, so there were 6 weeks. They're now almost 7 weeks old on Monday. So 6.5 weeks. And here we have probably about 10%, 15% more over, just for some which are not going to be quite at the right quality that we would require. But this variety here that we have has been a very much a star for us last year. This was Moon Glow, and so you can see the plant now. It's lovely and green. It's got the truss buds just starting to show. I don't know if you can pick that up on the camera. And when you're growing the plant, it's nice to see that the head is flat like that. That's very, very important. Pick another one out here, and that you have the head like that. It's nice and flat. Then at night time, these leaves just curl in there into the center there like that. So this, at night time it curls. That's showing you that you have the feed and the balance correct in the nutrition that the crop is having. So we've put the tomatoes from the 30 cell trays into 13 centimeter pots, as I just showed you. This is 26 varieties that we have here. There's another 5 varieties to come. There's tomatillo to come. There's a special beef tomato. There's one that we use for sun-dried tomatoes, that's San Marzano. So we have quite an array. So a mixture of beef tomatoes, different coloured ones like black zebra, green zebra, white zebra, red zebra, all giving stripy beef tomatoes. We have mini plum, we have ox heart, beef heart tomatoes, courtney-burr, pink ox heart. We have 26 varieties here, which gives us a nice spread. And these will stay here now for another 3 to 4 weeks. When the plant will reach the top of the cane. We have the lights not fully operational, as you see. We've just got a few more to put up, but they'll be illuminated now for 15-16 hours a day. So when we have a day like today and we have natural sunshine, we don't use the lights. They have natural light, that's fine. But if we have cold, wet, rainy days, that's looking like we will have this coming week, we will have the lights on to give the plant that power, that boost. So we've potted them all up. They all sit in the gutters. That's for us to be ease for carrying them out and for watering. We will also very soon put out the yellow sticky traps. That attracts all the bugs, all the flies and all the things which are buzzing around, hopefully not too many. So we use sticky traps. We also have companion planting. So we plant other plants with the tomatoes, like marigolds, like garlic, like parsley, like chives. That helps to keep the plants growing pest-free. So then we can not use chemicals in the process of our growing. So this is how the plants should look come early March. These are plants that were planted out. This is all in the grow bags in the glasshouse last spring. But you can have plants that are looking like this. Now is the time for you to sow your seed, the middle of February. You can grow your plants in a small pot, don't have to use a big tray. You will have lovely juicy plants to give you lovely juicy tomatoes. Here's some of the fruits that we have produced, all from the farm, all organically grown with no chemicals. Really tasty product. And as you see, some of the beef tomatoes are quite meaty, quite big, 685 grams for one fruit. We have had fruits up to 1 kilo per tomato. So we're growing many varieties. You have many choices and a lovely colourful plate that you have to choose from. And you can have that by doing your own if you wish. You can start growing now.